And now we will learn how landlords would manage their chart of accounts. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What is the chart of accounts? Well, in the days before the computer, the chart of accounts was called the general ledger. It was simply a notebook where each page in the book was a separate record of a different thing that the company had to account for. For example, page one was video income. That means every time they performed that particular service, they would write it down on page one. Page six was repair expense. That means every time they paid for that particular expense, they would write it down on page six. This way, they could get the total of page one and know the total video income they earned, and they could get the total of page six and know the total repair expense they had. Each page was called an account because it would account for the records of that item. Nowadays, we don't call it the general ledger. It's the same idea, but physically it's in the computer, so we call it the chart of accounts. So, an account is an individual record of transactions. You need an account for each bank account, credit card account, income source, and expense that your company has. Now, after you create your QBO account, QuickBooks gives everybody 23 to 24 standard accounts in the chart of accounts. That's simply the way QuickBooks Online behaves in the current 2019 version. It was different in earlier versions, and it probably will be different in future versions, but I'm recording this in 2019, which means you cannot delete any of the standard accounts that QuickBooks has given you in your chart of accounts. Unfortunately, you must make them inactive, which simply means removing them from the list. And of course, don't worry, you could always reactivate the accounts if needed. So, what am I talking about? Well, in order to get to the chart of accounts, you would click accounting. And notice you have two choices, or it flashed on the screen, chart of accounts and reconcile. Now, since this is the very first time that we're opening the chart of accounts window, you will not see the chart of accounts when you click here. You will instead see this green button, see your chart of accounts, because it's the very first time you're opening the window in this account. So we click the green button and now we can see the standard set of accounts that are automatically given to everyone who opens up a brand new, I guess it's 26 accounts, and opens up a brand new QBO account. So how do we manage this? Well, this is the chart of accounts that we need to put. And I explained this a moment ago. These are the accounts that a landlord or property manager would need. Well, how am I going to get them into this? How am I going to get the accounts with these names and these types? We will not address the issue of detail type in this course. Just follow the example, and of course, you could read the reading material in QBO if you feel it necessary. Now, this is the sample chart of accounts that we will use for this course. Most of them are in capital letters. I suggest you put them in with capital letters. This way, your eyes can clearly distinguish between the accounts that we put ourselves and the accounts that QuickBooks put automatically. Notice it has both account name and account type for each of the accounts that we're going to put. Now, account name can be anything you want, as long as you know what that means. You can spell it any way you want, but keep in mind, whatever you type in for account name is exactly the way it will show up on any of the QuickBooks reports. But regarding account type, you have to be very careful that you choose the correct type. Now, please note, account type in QuickBooks is not the same thing as account type when studying accounting theory. Account type in QuickBooks simply determines how it behaves in the software as we use it. Please view the supplemental video about called Defending the Method, which means I will explain why the account types are the types that I have chosen in order to get the file to work properly, specifically for a property manager or a landlord. So please watch that supplemental video, and in the meantime, please cooperate along with what we request that you do when we ask you to put the specific account types for the specific names. To customize the chart of accounts, so the accounts that QuickBooks Online has given us becomes the accounts that we need. First, we have to try to make inactive any of the ones we're not using. But any account that we can't make inactive, we should simply change to the ones that we need. So, how do we do that? Well, let's take a look. For example, this uncategorized asset. That's not on this list, or actually this list, right? So let's try to make it inactive. Click here and click Make Inactive. Are you sure? Yes. Now, it says it's part of the online banking feature, so that's an example of one that you just have to leave on your list and ignore. What about this, owner's investment? Okay, we click here. Oops, excuse me, if you accidentally click here, you can click back. Click the pull down arrow and click Make Inactive. Are you sure? Yes. Well, that one was allowed to be removed as inactive. I'll bet you this one. I'll bet you billable expenses income, we're definitely not going to need that. Watch what happens. Again, click the arrow and click Make Inactive and click Yes. And it allows us to do that. Now, don't worry. The accounts are still there. Even if you scroll down, you won't see them on the list because right now you're only viewing active accounts. But if you click this cogwheel, you have the ability to click this check mark and say, you know what? Include the inactive accounts. And notice, after we click away to save it, notice uncategorized asset has returned and billable expenses has returned. And to indicate that they have been made inactive, they have parentheses deleted. So now we can see them and we can open them up if we need to or do whatever we need if they were on the list before. Okay, so now we'll just remove the check mark and they will take it off. So let's just try and make as many inactive as we can as long as the video runs, and any ones that remain will decide how we want to change them into the accounts that we need. Okay, sales, I think we can, let's go make inactive. Are you sure? Yes. Okay, so it won't let us do that because it's connected to an item, and we will learn about items in the following video. But uncategorized income, let's see if it lets us do that. Make inactive, yes. Well, it won't let us take that one off either. What about advertising and marketing? Okay, make inactive, yes. It lets us do that. Okay, what about bank fees? And of course, some of these we're going to put back on when we add the accounts. But what about bank fees? Okay, make inactive. Does it let us take it off? Yes. Do as many as you can. Car and truck. You don't need a car and truck if you're a landlord. You can take it off. Job supplies. We'll put a different account that's better. Make inactive. Yes. Okay, and so on. Rent and lease. Make inactive. Yes. And of course, if you ever need to see the inactive ones, boom, you can click here and you can see they're put back on the list and you can see they're deleted. And of course, you could always reactivate them by clicking make active. Now, when I remove this and I show only the active ones, you can see that reimbursable expenses has been put back on the list. So what I'm going to do is pause the video and make as many inactive as I can, and I suggest you do the same. Then when we come back, we will add the ones that we need. Now after making as many as I can inactive, I notice that these five I'm simply stuck with. So we will simply leave them on our list in the chart of accounts and disregard them as we add the ones that we need. And again, these are the ones that a landlord would need. Now, a quick note. QBO, QuickBooks Online, has both an account type and a detail type for the accounts. Usually, the detail type means nothing, and you can just use judgment based on the name. But it's only important in one case, undeposited funds. If you look at the third account down on the list, you will see that we're going to add undeposited funds. And you can see that it's a other current asset, but in addition to telling QuickBooks Online that this is another other current asset, we're also going to tell QuickBooks Online that this is specifically undeposited funds. That is the only time that detail type matters. All the other times, detail type will not matter. So we come back here, and then we go to the top right. We're still in the accounting chart of accounts area in QuickBooks Online, and we click New. And we get the new account window. Now, the first one is named cash and bank, and it's a bank type of account. So that's what we'll put. It's a bank type of account. The detail type is something like checking in this case. And we will call it, whatever the name it says, cash and bank. Okay, put it in all caps so we know we're the ones who made it. Cash in bank. Good. Now, you could either go save and close or save and new. If you're putting in a list, it's better to click save and new because it will save it and keep the window open. Now, the next one, the type is accounts receivable, which is fine, but the name should be unearned rental income. So in capital letters, we'll put unearned rental income and then click save and new. And it will go on the list. If you take a peek behind you, you'll see the new ones are coming on the list, but we don't want to break our momentum. Now, the third one is undeposited funds. And again, it's the only one where the detail type matters. So we're going to choose other current asset. And for detail type, we'll choose undeposited funds. That's the only one where detail type matters. And we'll even leave the name undeposited funds in lowercase to indicate it was something that QuickBooks put. Save and new, and it's on the list. What's next? Holden's investment, and that's equity. Now, unfortunately, we actually deleted one that was here that we could have changed into that. But let's just put, I think the closest to this is partner's equity. So we'll leave it at that. It really doesn't matter. And we'll name it Holden's investment. And this will be the account that represents all the money that Holden Holden's investment. Save and new. And what's next on the list? Holden's withdrawals. Also an equity account. So we go to the type of equity and let's see if we can get, partners distributions, I think, is the closest to Holden's withdrawals. Okay, save and new, very good. Okay, now, what's next on the list? You don't have to put an opening balance equity and retained earnings, but you should put income from late fees as an income type of account. So we go down here and we find income type of account. And for sub account, service fee income, I think is more appropriate. But again, in this case, the detail type won't affect us. And we'll put the name that we're supposed to put for the course, rental income earned. And we're going to click this time, save and close, because I want to take a peek at what we've put so far. Now, here's the chart of accounts that we put so far. Notice the ones that we put have the name in capital, except, of course, undeposited funds. But it doesn't have everything we need yet. What you have to do is you have to keep going until all of these accounts are in the list in the chart of accounts for the correct name and the correct type. And from this point forward, you don't have to worry too much about detail type. Just use your judgment, and if you choose the wrong detail type, I assure you it will not affect anything you do for the rest of the course. Just make sure account type is correct and that the names are correct. And when you finish, I will show you what the chart of accounts looks like. So I'm going to pause the video and put in the rest and then show you what it looks like. Now this is what your final chart of accounts should look like. Here are the names, types, and detail type. Don't worry so much that your detail type doesn't match mine, but you know, I'm going to scroll down very slowly so that you can see what I put and try to make your chart of accounts exactly the same as mine. Remember, if you mess up, you could either just edit the account or make it inactive and put it again on the list. You can edit an account, but some account types, the detail type, usually it will let you change, but some account types, QuickBooks may or may not let you change. And you might have to just make the account inactive and re-enter it brand new. So again, I'm going to go very slowly, and these are the choices I made for detail type. And now we have everything we need regarding the chart of accounts to manage our property records.